So in solution, in previously we discussed the up to part 6. So next we go to the part 7. So in the part 7, our topic is the colligative properties. So the colligative properties, simple meaning, what is the mean by the colligative properties? So the properties which can be depend on the number of solute particles. So the type of properties is called as a colligative properties. So colligative properties means it can be depend on the only number of solute particles, number of solute particles in the solution. So the type of properties is called as a colligative properties. So this colligative properties can be depend on the only number of solute particles. It do not depend on the number of solvent particles. It can be depend on the nature of the solvent particles. Means colligative properties, the properties which can be depend on the number of solute particles, or another one is the nature of the solvent particles. So the type of properties is called as a colligative properties. So here this colligative properties, total 4 types of the colligative properties will be present. And the first one is the relative lowering in vapor pressure. Already we have to know that is the P0 minus PS by P0. And second one is the elevation in boiling point. That will be indicated with the delta TB. Elevation in the boiling point. Elevation means nothing but scientific meaning is the increase. So increase in the boiling point. So that is the delta TB. Next one is the depression in freezing point, delta TF. Depression in freezing point. Depression means nothing but decrease. Decrease in the freezing point. That is the depression in freezing point. And fourth one is the osmotic pressure. That will be indicated with the symbol pi. So these are the 4 types of the colligative properties. Here mainly why here we can discuss the colligative properties means by using this colligative property, we should measure the molar mass of the solute in the solution. Molar mass. These are used for determination of the molar mass of the solute particles in the solution. Molar mass means nothing but molecular weight of the solute. Molar mass means nothing but what is that? Molecular weight of the solute. So by using the colligative properties, by using the these 4 types of the colligative property, listen carefully, by using the these 4 types of the colligative properties, we should measure the molar mass of the solute, nothing but molecular weight of the solute. This is the use of the colligative properties. So here we discuss the one by one. First one, we move to the relative lowering in vapor pressure. So that is the relative lowering in vapor pressure. So already we have to know the relative lowering in vapor pressure means that is indicated with the P0 minus PS by P0. So already we have to know the P0 minus PS by P0 means the ratio between the lowering in vapor pressure and vapor pressure of the solvent. The ratio between the lowering in vapor pressure and vapor pressure of the solvent. So that is called as a relative lowering in vapor pressure. So already we have to know the from Raoult's law. So the relative lowering in vapor pressure, P0 minus PS by P0. From Raoult's law, that is equals to mole fraction of the solute. So from Raoult's law, the relative lowering in vapor pressure, P0 minus PS by P0. This is the relative lowering in vapor pressure. It is equals to the mole fraction of the solute. So already we have to know the mole fraction of the solute. Means P0 minus PS by P0 is equals to mole fraction of solute means nothing but number of moles of solute is divided by number of moles of the solute plus number of moles of the solvent. So P0 minus PS by P0 is equals to number of moles of the solute divided by number of moles of the solute plus number of moles of the solvent. So already we have to know the Raoult's law is applicable for dilute solutions. So it is applicable for dilute solutions. Already we have to know the dilute solution means solute quantity is very, very less compared with the solvent quantity. So solute quantity is less than compare with the solvent quantity. Similarly, number of moles of the solute is also less than with number of moles of the solvent. So when number of moles of solute quantity is very less, so if it is attached with the number of moles of solvent, it is approximately equal to the number of moles of the solvent. So in dilute solutions, what is mean the dilute solution? The solute quantity is less compared with the solvent quantity. So when solute quantity is less means number of moles of solute is also less compared with the number of moles of the solvent. So less quantity is added with the large quantity, means number of solute plus number of moles of solvent is approximately equal to the number of moles of the solvent. So in denominator, number of moles of the solute plus number of moles of the solvent will be present. It is based on the mole fraction formula. So from that, it is applicable for the dilute solutions. So the equation is changes as P naught minus PS by P naught is equals to number of moles of solute in denominator, number of moles of solute plus number of moles of solvent is equals to number of moles of solvent. So in denominator is written as a number of moles of solvent. So already we have to know the number of moles means the formula of number of moles is the weight by gram molecular weight. Already we have to know number of moles means weight by gram molecular weight on substitution. So equation is changes as P naught minus PS by P naught is equals to number of moles of solute means weight of solute by gram molecular weight of solute into gram molecular weight of solvent divided by weight of solvent. So from this equation, we should find out the gram molecular weight of the solute, gram molecular weight of solute on cross multiplication. Finally, we get the W solute into GNW solvent into P naught divided by P naught minus PS into W solvent. So this is the final equation can be obtained by using the relative lowering in vapor pressure. So already in starting we explained the relative lowering in vapor pressure. It is one of the colligative property. So that colligative property is used for determination of the molar mass of the solute, nothing but gram molecular weight of the solute. So from that relative lowering in vapor pressure, we should find out the finally gram molecular weight of the solute. Here that formula is the gram molecular weight of solute is equals to W solute into GMW solvent into P naught by P naught minus PS into W solvent. So this is the final equation is used to determination of the molar mass of the solute. So in this formula, W solute means weight of the solute, G and W solvent means gram molecular weight of solvent, P naught means vapor pressure of the solvent, naught means always it is indicates the solvent. So P naught means vapor pressure of the solvent, and PS means vapor pressure of the solution. Already we have to know W solvent means weight of the solvent. So this is the final equation is used to determination of the molar mass of the solute by using the which colligative property? Starting one, that is the relative lowering in vapor pressure. So from this equation, it is clearly observed. So the relative lowering in vapor pressure means that is the P naught minus PS by P naught. P naught minus PS by P naught. But when we observe the final equation, that P naught minus PS by P naught is reverse. That is the P naught by P naught minus PS. P naught by P naught minus PS. That means from that equation, from that relation, we should say the molar mass of the solute, gram molecular weight of the solute is inversely proportional to the relative lowering in vapor pressure. So gram molecular weight of solute, nothing but molar mass of the solute, is inversely proportional to the relative lowering in vapor pressure colligative property. Okay, no? So this is the relative lowering in vapor pressure. Next colligative property, that is the elevation in boiling point. Elevation in boiling point means nothing but increase in boiling point. So when boiling point will be increases. So already we have to know the solution. Solution means it is the mixture of the solute and the solvent. So solvent, when we add it to the solute, to the solvent, then that solvent is converted to the solution form. So solvent, solute is added to the solvent, then it gives the solution. So when the solvent is converted to the solution form, its boiling point will be increases. When the solvent is converted to the solution form, its boiling point will be increases. That is called as a increasing boiling point, or nothing but elevation in boiling point. Simple meaning, when the solute, when the solvent is converted to the solution form, its boiling point will be increases. So that is called as a increase in boiling point, nothing but elevation in boiling point. That is indicated with the delta TB. So delta TB is equals to TS minus T naught. So where the delta TB is the elevation, nothing but increase, elevation in boiling point. TS means boiling point of, S means solution, boiling point of solution. T naught, T naught, naught means already previously we should explain the solvent. So T naught means boiling point of solvent, boiling point of solvent. So solvent is converted to the solution, then the boiling point will be increases. So simply that is called as a elevation in boiling point, or increase in boiling point. So this is simple representation of the graphical model. So in this graph, on the x-axis we use the temperature, on the y-axis we are using the vapor pressure. So here the meaning of the boiling point, first we should know the, already you know the boiling point meaning. Boiling point means the temperature at which, the temperature at which vapor pressure is equal to the atmospheric pressure. So that is called as a boiling point. So due to that, here we draw the graph between the vapor pressure and temperature. The temperature at which vapor pressure is equal to the atmospheric pressure, that temperature will be called as a boiling point. So here we draw the graph between the temperature and vapor pressure. Here this AB curve will be indicates the solvent. So when we are adding the solute, the solvent, then it is converted to the solution. So this CD curve is indicates the solution. So here this is the temperature, that means boiling point of the solvent. When it is converted to the solution, its boiling point will be increases. Boiling point will be increases. So here this point is indicate the boiling point of the solution. Here this gap is indicates the delta TB, means elevation in boiling point. That is the TS minus T naught. TS minus T naught will be called as a elevation in boiling point. That is the delta TB. So from thermodynamic relations, the elevation in boiling point is directly proportional to the molality of the solution. So where the small m is the molality, molality of the solution. So when we remove the proportionality, already we have to know, we get the constant. Here that constant can be indicated with the KB. So delta TB is equals to KB into m, where the KB is called as a molar elevation boiling point constant, or another name for that KB is the ebullioscopic constant. So ebullioscopic constant or molar elevation in boiling point constant. So from that delta TB is equals to KB into M molality. So already we have to know the molality formula. So molality is equals to weight by gram molecular weight of solute into 1000 by weight of the solvent. So this is the formula of the molality. So that formula can be substituted in this equation. Then that equation is converted to delta TB is equals to KB into molality formula, weight of solute divided by gram molecular weight of solute into 1000 by A in gram. So from this equation, we should find out the, on cross multiplication, gram molecular weight of solute is equals to KB into W solute into 1000 divided by delta TB into A in grams. So this is the final equation. So from this equation, same concept, that is the molar mass of the solute, nothing but gram molecular weight of the solute, can be determined by using the colligative property. Here that colligative property is the elevation in boiling point, that is the delta TB. That means when we have to know the KB value, or weight of solute value, or weight of solvent value, or delta TB, here we are substituted that all values in this equation. Finally, we are get the gram molecular weight of the solute, nothing but molar mass of the solute. So this is the second colligative property, elevation in boiling point. By using that elevation in boiling point, finally we should find out the what is that molar mass of the solute, nothing but gram molecular weight of the solute. Simple meaning, when we observe this equation, here the relation between the molar mass of the solute and delta TB is the inversely proportional. In previously, also relative lowering in vapor pressure is inversely proportional to the molar mass of the solute. Same, elevation in boiling point is also inversely proportional to the molar mass of the solute. So from this equation, we should find out the molar mass of the solute by using the second colligative property, that is the elevation in boiling point. So for example, here this equation, from this equation, delta TB is equals to KB into M. From that equation, delta TB is equals to KB into M. Here in this equation, we should substitute the molality, M is equals to 1. So delta TB is equals to KB. KB means ebullioscopic constant. KB is equals to delta TB. What is that? KB is equals to delta TB in which condition? When the solution molality is equals to the 1. When the molality is equals to the 1, the type of solutions is called as a molal solution. Molality, 1 means molal solution. Means the ebullioscopic constant is defined as a for molal solution. Means molality is equals to 1. For molal solution, delta TB is called as a KB. Delta TB is called as a KB. For which type of solution? Molality is equals to 1 type of solution. Means nothing but for molal solution, elevation in boiling point is called as a ebullioscopic constant. Delta TB means nothing but elevation in boiling point is called as a ebullioscopic constant. Okay, no? So that is the meaning of the ebullioscopic constant.